Hello guys, welcome back. In this video we'll be learning about why are the chromosomes named X and Y, what is the first chromosome, what is the last chromosome, why there are 23 pairs of chromosomes, so on and so forth. We'll be answering the questions. All right, in the previous video we learned that the cells have the basic structure, not the acidic, and they have the nitrogenous bases, right, which are the ATGCU. Now these nitrogenous bases, upon combination with the sugar, they form nucleoside with phosphorus nucleotide. Chain of nucleotide is known as nucleic acid. Okay, now this nucleic acid, when one chain of nucleic acid combines with the other chain of the nucleic acid, this is known as DNA. All right, now when many pairs of DNA are compressed, this is known as chromatin. Okay, so you can remember is DNA compressed in a tin, chromatin. All right, so this is one pair of DNA you can see clearly. When the DNA is compressed to the maximum extent, this is known as a chromatid. Okay, so this is what is chromatid. It is compressed to maximum extent. Okay, now when two chromatids combine, all right, this is known as a chromosome. So here is what is the chromosome. Okay, now we have 23 pairs of chromosomes in every cell of our body. Pairs because one of the chromosome comes from the mother and other chromosome comes from the father. All right, now excuse me, one chromatid comes from mother and another from father. Now these are similar but they are not identical. Similar in the way because they perform or control the same function. Because say if chromosome first, if the first chromatid controls say the curliness of hair from the mother, okay, and the father's chromosome, the same first chromosome will also control the same function, but they are not identical. Say mother can have a blonde hair, the father can have a black hair. A combination of blonde or black hair may be seen here. Or if mother has a blonde hair, father has a curly hair, and the child may get a curly blonde hair. All right, I think we are quite clear with that. All right, so they both control the hair characteristics, but they are not same. Okay, one gives different characters, other gives different characters for the same organ of the body. All right, now in total there are 23 pairs of chromosome, right? Now first 22 chromosomes are known as autosomes. The 23rd pair of chromosomes are known as allosomes. They are the sex chromosomes. Well, for the female we have the XX. These are named. Now these X control the female sex characters. For example, it controls the egg production, periods, childbirth, etc. Now X also controls the factors such as the blood clotting, brain development and color vision, and hence since these are very important for survival, these are also found in males. Okay, XY, so X controls these important survival characteristics. Y controls the functions such as sperm production, testis development. Now chromosomes are named / numbered according to the size. The first pair of chromosomes are the biggest in size. All right. On the other hand, as we go down, that is, the second chromosome would be smaller than that of first chromosome. So 22nd pair of chromosomes would be the smallest. Right. All right. So the chromosomes are known as the homologous chromosomes. For example, the first chromosome, right? But the 23rd pair of chromosomes, these are heterologous, okay? Because it's X and Y for male, right? So females have 23 pairs of chromosomes, right? And the males have 22 pairs of chromosomes, homologous chromosomes, right? Now one set of all chromosome, okay, so you can see here, one set of all the 23 chromosomes, like first chromosome, second chromosome, this one column is known as ploid. The humans are diploid, that is, they have two pairs of 23 chromosomes each. Now triploid is not possible. Triploid to octoploid, these are also known as polyploids. Okay, now polyploids, application of polyploids is the genetically modified plants, and it's used to increase the size or the food quantity. Okay, now haploid of diploid means half. Okay, half of diploid is monoploid. Next, a very important topic is chromosomal aberrations. Now this aberration can either be allosomal or it can be autosomal. Okay, I've already talked what is allosomal, means which are the non-sex chromosomes, and allosomals are the sex chromosomes, and autosomals are the non-sex chromosomes. Okay, 1 to 22. Let's talk first about autosomal aberrations. Now the syndrome. Okay, now the syndrome is known as Down syndrome. You know, just to honor the scientist who found it. Now, what exactly happens is that the 21st chromosome, three 21st chromosomes are found in the people suffering with the Down syndrome. Okay, so it's also known as 21st trisomy, and since the face is round, you have a broad forehead, this is also known as Mongolism. Okay, so the symptoms are, you have a small height, the face is round, and you don't attain a height more than 4 feet, you have a very broad forehead, the mouth is always open, the fingers are always small, there is low IQ, you are sterile because your sex organs aren't developed. Okay, so these are some of the symptoms. Right, now if we come to the sex chromosomes, and if we divide the,
okay, so let's understand this. Suppose meiosis happens, and it was not a normal meiosis. Now, since this was not a normal meiosis, that is division of cell, the haploids which were to form was not normal. So XX on both on the one side and a zero on the other side. So let's see what happens in this case. Now, if a sperm has Y chromosome in it, so the resulting would be XXY, forming the Klinefelter's syndrome. Okay, so 22 autosomes plus XXY. All right. Okay, so let's first discuss what are some of the symptoms of Klinefelter's syndrome. Okay, now the Klinefelter's syndrome since they are basically males, right? Because it's Y here. Okay. But since they have an extra X, so these are also known as feminized males. Okay, see, patients are phenotypically males, means on the front they seem to be males, but they exhibit some female characters. All right, and they have small testes, they have small penis, and they have less bodily hairs, they have female like voice, and they have low energy level, as because they have less testosterone level, their facial hair is very less. Okay, and in fact you can see the process of gynecomastia, which is the presence of the manly boobs. All right, okay. So 22, these are 22 pairs of autosomes, so that makes it to be 44. 2 here, XY, that makes it to be 46, and plus 1. So there are total 47 chromosome in this person with suffering with Kleene filter syndrome. All right, next. Now, if the if the sperm had X, okay, so it will form XXX, and that's what is super female syndrome. All right, so again, as it was here, 47 chromosomes here also. Now, super female syndrome, they are females, first of all, since no Y chromosome, and they are infertile, they are intellectually retarded. Since they have extra chromosome, they are tall, and you will find epicentric fold. Okay, so the next is, the other cell was, there was no chromosome left. Now, if the male sperm comes and it has the X, right? So, XO is formed, okay? So, here, since there are zero chromosomes, here what you will find, 22 pairs of autosomals, that makes it to be 44. Plus 1, 45. Okay, so they lack one chromosome. Since found by some scientist with Turner name, hence the name Turner. Now, since they don't have Y, so it will be found in females. Now, the term Turner syndrome again is quite similar to the super female syndrome, because they are infertile, they are mentally retarded people. Okay, they have less life expectancy. Okay. Since they are sterile and they can't give baby, they have underdeveloped uterus, and their chest is broad, and they seem to be more like a boy, because their breasts are not developed, and they don't have any menstrual cycle. Okay, and they have short webbed neck. Okay, the neck, there you'll find an extra skin. Okay, these are short people, unlike super female syndrome, which are relatively tall people. So you won't find a Turner syndrome girl to be more than 5 feet, and they have some hearing deficiency. All right, so that was all about Turner syndrome. Now, the last is the super male syndrome. Okay, before super male syndrome, if the Y chromosome of sperm comes here, Y0 will form, but that won't be able to form a zygote, because Y0 you won't find, as I've already told, how X is important for life. Okay. So finally, we have super male syndrome. These have extra Y chromosome in it. Again, 47 chromosomes, and very tall. These people are very aggressive. They have high testosterone level, and this aggression leads to the criminal attitude. These people have criminal attitude. All right. Next, we come to the cell. Now, the cell are of two types, somatic cell and reproductive cell. Somatic cells are the bodily cells. For example, skin cells, hair cells, okay, your nails. Every cell, if you take a skin cell of a male, it will have, 22 pairs of autosomes, X chromosome and a Y chromosome. Okay, so these are diploid. Now, if female is taken, every cell would have, every cell would have both the X and X, okay? So, these are diploids again. But the reproductive cells, for example, the sperm cells, they are haploid. Why haploid? Because both of them need to give their chromosomes, all right? Now, since both of the parents need to give their chromosomes, if it would have been a diploid again, so the child would have been tetraploid. Okay, as I've already told, tetraploid in humans is not possible. Okay, so excuse me again.
egg cell has only this one type, and the sperm cell have it either can be X or it can either can be Y. When the X combines with this, it forms a girl, and the Y when this Y combines with the egg cell, and these form the male counterpart, right? So after learning what is somatic cell and what is the reproductive cell and why the egg cells are haploid but the bodily cells are the diploid, next we move to what is fertilization. Okay, so when the egg cell and the sperm cell they fuse, it forms a zygote. So zygote is the first cell formed in the life, and this fusion is called fertilization, right? Now after this, the cell division takes place, and you know, embryo is formed. No, from one cell to many cells, and you can say group of cell is called embryo. But as you know, the embryo is a stage which are undifferentiated mass of cells. That is, as we know that the organs have differentiated cell types. The eyes have different cells as compared to your nails or your or for your hand, right? So that differentiation takes place in the fetus. Fetus is still in the womb. After that, it comes into the world, right? Now next we'll see what are the twins. Now twins can be divided into three parts: the dizygotic, the monozygotic, and the conjoint. The dizygotic twins actually they produce, these are also known as non-identical twins, okay? And you know, just like two brothers and sisters, so fraternal twins. And this happens because suppose two eggs are produced. Many times a female produce more than 2x. More than 2x are released. So when 2x are released, and two sperms act on it, zygote forms, embryo forms, and this is, it either can be two female, two male, or a male and a female. But in monozygotic, it's quite different. A single egg is released and fertilized by a sperm, leading to formation of zygote. This zygote turns it to embryo. Now this embryo, it breaks apart. So since it was a single egg and single sperm, it can either be a male, or it both can be male, or both can be female. It can't be male or female, right? Right. So it won't be brothers and sisters, brother and a sister. It would be brothers, it would be sisters. So next is conjoint. Now the same process, but the zygote, the embryo was not able to break apart, so forming Siamese twins. It can be either be joined by head, by you know, the shoulders, so on and so forth. It can be many cases. So that's all. Thank you.